Alright, so we say that this is with the sun. This is Dordorim, one and two generation. What it's what we call Isha, the woman. Like we did the Gimetia with the three angels that equal three times Isha and the three words that equal three times Isha, the same Gimetia. And this call Lifnei Yareach, before the moon, one, two generations, that equal sun plus the moon. And this is the concept of the mule. It is the concept of the horse. This is the concept of the mule, and this is the concept of the donkey. Okay, so here we have the moon, Yareach, or without moon, Liareach, you can call it, Liareach, because I talk about the physical of the moon, not the light of the moon. Liareach equal 140, two times I. Like here we have the two eyes, here we have the two eyes. But the sun is only one eyes and the moon is only one eyes.
Eye.
Eye. So they are connected together. You cannot one with not with without the other. Here the dominant is the left eye, it means the eyes that represent the donkey. Here is the dominant is the horse. It's why we call it the horse. And he receives the color from the black donkey. Here the dominant is it's the donkey, so we call it white donkey, but he receives the white color from the horse. Okay? So this is a mule, this is a combination of the sun and the moon. This is this guy is a priest. He came, he ride on a white horse. This one ride on the white horse. This woman. This is Avram. Now we have the three, the all the generated the faces. Afur. This is Avram, donkey equal Avram. This is Yitzhak. Yitzhak is a left. Is red. He need a red horse. This is Yaakov, the face, the tiferet, face, the face of a man. This is a rectification of the first man as well. The chaya is the level of the first man before he did before a sin, before he did a sin. Okay, the first man before his sin is the level of the chaya. This is the level of the King Yoshia, or what is. Rabbi Menachem Mendel Schneerson, what you call the sun. So this one have, we call him the black horse, but really is the white horse. And this is that equal Yarok, that equal green in Gimetia, riding on the green, light green horse.
Can you explain why green, light green? Why this color?
This is the color of Jesus, and he receives the color green from the plant. The plant is green, okay, from the donkey.
Tiferet is the color of Tiferet.
No, this is green is the Tiferet of Sphira of Yesod. Like we said, it corresponds to Yosef. We have all lesson about all the color. Compared to the attribute of the heart, so everybody can serve this lesson and understand the logic of the different color in the seven attributes of the heart. Okay, so this horse we call it Sus Yerakrak, that equal my name is Yeshua. This one riding on the black horse, this guy riding on the red horse. Now, who is the red horse? This, you call it the disciple, the moon. What is above the moon, you call it the rabbi.
Dordorim.
Dordorim is a rabbi, one, two generation. The biggest rabbi in the world, after the rabbi passed away, this called, this is the biggest rabbi today in the world. No, the biggest rabbi in the world.
World.
Have to do Nazi Pidyon Ben in the name of the rab, of the rabbi. He have to pay the $2 million in the name of the rabbi. To do it, the rabbi must to be reincarnated inside him. If he don't receive the chaye, he cannot do it. He have to do it for the rabbi. For the rabbi, he have to do what the rabbi didn't realize in his life.
You mean Ibur Neshama?
Ibur Neshama, reincarnation of the soul. You know when
it's like receiving Ruach HaKodesh, it's something similar.
It's not Ruach HaKodesh, it's a particular soul. Sometimes a soul finishes his life in this world and he missed a commandment. Something he didn't perform all his life, he didn't have the opportunity to do it, and he died. Now, what he's going to do? He's going to reincarnate himself in a soul that can do it.
In a body, his soul.
Reincarnation of soul in a soul.
Gilgul Neshama.
It's a Gilgul inside the soul. It's the Gilgul is not inside the body. It's not a new body born. Yeah. It's not a new person that called Rabbi Schneerson will born here.
No, it's just Ibur Neshama.
It's Ibur Neshama inside the lowest level of the Neshama. This Neshama will get pregnant with the Rabbi. And
just like getting the consciousness of the rabbi into a body.
All right, so this rabbi have the consciousness of the rabbi. It's why he can do the Pidyon HaBen. The moment he do the Pidyon HaBen, he did the rectification for Yoshiyahu, for the Rabbi Schneerson, the act of Pidyon HaBen. So now, in the moment this happened, he paid the Pidyon HaBen. The Pidyon HaBen is to receive Yechida.
Yes.
He received Jesus too. Yeah. If not, he's not Mashiach. Alright, so the Rabbi must to be, in the moment we do the Pidyon HaBen, in this ceremony, the Rabbi must to be there inside the Rabbi.
So for people to understand, when you say, you're talking about Ibur Neshama, it's about the consciousness of a big rabbi that kind of...
It's a soul that...
Participate in a spiritual, we're not talking about mysticism or something, it's just something that happens.
It's something that happened in the world that related to
it's about consciousness.
What we talk about this. We talk about the soul of Olam Atzilut.
Right.
It's like what you call God is Olam Atzilut, Yudke Vavke.
So I just made a parallel to the Ruach HaKodesh.
The place of Yudke Vavke is here. This is above the name of God. You have to understand this. This is the crown of the name of God. And still, it's the outside of the crown and it's the inner of the crown.
Yeah,
only the inner of the crown you can say that this is God.
Yeah, I was just making a parallel for people to understand. It's like receiving the Ruach HaKodesh, like the Holy Spirit somehow, the presence of something above, it's something similar in that sense, so people shouldn't... Thank
you. All Christianity talk about spiritual birth. What is a spiritual birth? I receive Jesus.
Okay. No. This is similar in that sense.
But if we talk about a real Jesus, a real Yechida, a real Adam Kadmon, you need to have all this level of the soul perfect. Mm-hmm. There are not people in this world that have this full level.
Very few people.
Nobody. It's not exist.
It's like a whole man, Ben Adam
to
Shalem.
To be a Ben Adam Shalem with this, in this world, when Ben Adam, everybody receives the Nefesh.
The level of consciousness
is Nefesh, most of the people.
Spiritual.
Now, in the moment he fixed the Nefesh, he died. And when he come back to another life, he will receive the Ruach. Now he will start to fix the Ruach. He finished to fix the Ruach, he died. He finished. Now he will come back with the Neshama. Sometimes, rarely, a person fixes Nefesh and is not die. he will receive the ruach. He's
during
still
his
alive.
Lifetime, Gilgul Neshama.
It's like he born a new person.
Born again.
To a completely new world of consciousness.
So a new level of consciousness.
This is the world of the angel. And then he receives the ruach. And then he finished to feel the ruach in the same lifetime and he receives the neshama. The neshama, it means the consciousness of Olam HaBriya. Of the angel person.
Very, very high level of consciousness of reality.
It's not happened.
Very rare.
It's something very rare. All right. So when I talk about the rabbi, I talk about a rabbi that fixed this three level of the soul.
Very high.
And now
level of enlightenment.
And now the soul that represents the chaya, the adam with no sin, is not yet mashiach, but is the level of the chaya before the sin, the first man, the way he was created. So now this level.
It's like fixing the original sin, receiving the chaya, right? It's like putting together the. Is that the level of consciousness?
To fix the chaya, it means to redeem, to eat the tree of knowledge, good and evil, in a good way, in a way that is connect to the tree of life that. He gives you eternal life and he gives you the connection to the Yechida, what has to do with eternal life.
So only at that level he can receive the Yechida.
Only in this level. Alright, so we talk about a person and he didn't fix the physical body. The one that represents the physical body, he didn't fix the physical body too. It's a regular person, a normal person, just represents this quality. He talk in the name of this quality. He talk in the name of the Father. This is what we call the advocate, the praklit. Okay? The Mashiach will be one with the body, with the physical body only in the resurrection of the dead. And then, the full name of Jesus will be Yehoshua. Not Yeshua. Yehoshua or Yeshua with A in the end. Yeshua.
By salvation.
Salvation, Yeshua. Alright, so this only the resurrection of the dead will happen.
Like redemption? Yeshua is like the same, is the translation redemption?
Yeshua is redemption, but it's missing a letter to be Yeshua.
Yeah.
We don't say Yeshua.
With a hey at the end.
You must have a hey to be Yeshua. This perfect,
so
completely end of redemption, this is the end of the door of Mashiach. What is what you call the resurrection of the dead?
The latest, the last stage.
The last state of rectification. After this, it's a new world completely. It's a new existence here. After this will be the millennium of the 1,000
years. 1,000
years
of peace.
Yeah.
After the 6,000 years.
Yeah. Okay? So all these things have to happen before the starting of the 7,000 last year. Okay, now. Explain this again in a different way. This is the letter Aleph, and this is the letter Aleph. This is a Yud K Vav K, you can say. More precisely, we talk about connection between rabbi and disciple. So this is a disciple. This is a donkey riding on the white horse. This is Talmid.
You just draw two Aleph.
Two Aleph.
Higher.
This is the crown. This
and lower.
This world where we live. This is the disciple, this is the donkey, this is the moon.
Talmid.
Now, this is the Rav, the rabbi. And this is what you call the woman, and this is what you call the mule. And this is a firmament that separates between high water and low water.
Rakia.
Rakia equal sus plus hamor. This is a horse, this is a donkey. This is a rakia separate high water, the high water is the horse, the low water is a donkey. This is the sun, this is the moon. Okay? And this equal Egypt. The Torah says about the Egyptians that they have a flash of donkey and a blood of ox, the body and the blood of Mashiach. And this equal Lubavitch. Lubavitch. 380. Rakia, firmament. This is a woman. This is the free generation. This is a rabbi. The rabbi, like we say, is Yeshai. He's symmetric. Here inside is a disciple that makes his rabbi wise. The disciple is like a son. Son of a woman equal Mashiach. Where is the father? The son is the father. How is the father? He makes his rabbi wise. He gives him the seed of Mashiach. But here is a place, the rabbi. So, where is this place? In the middle of Yishai. What is Shlomo? The sin of Shlomo. This is Shlomo, this is David, this is Yishai. Now this is again David, root of David, and this is again Shlomo. This is like Itikyomin, this is like Jesus. The root of David. This is the root of Yishai. This is called the root of Yishai. Okay? Explain the symmetry. This is the two wings of the eagle to support the woman. She has to receive the two wings of the eagle.
It's like the connection between this world and the above world.
So it is the eagle that There are two big eagles in the Bible. It is the biggest eagle represents the king of Babylon. This is parallel in holiness to the concept of Jesus that we call him eagle too. It is another eagle that is not so big like the eagle of Babylon. It's the eagle that represents a symbol of for the king of Egypt. It means the king of Egypt, what is Paro, is Menachem Mendelssohn. Okay? So this is symmetry, this represents the eagle. To receive the Chaya, it means to receive the possibility to fly.
So why do you have two Aleph? I mean, just in one sentence.
The crown is the upside down world, is the same reality in reverse. Noah find grace in the eyes of God. Inside God is another time Noah.
This is like two partsufim, this partsuf tachton velion. Sorry.
You look at me. You see the reflection of yourself in my eyes. This is here. Now, inside me, what I see, you. Is you outside of me and is you inside of me. I experience what I see. It means you are inside of my head. With what I see, with what I experience, I see you, I express you. Everything that I feel is inside. Outside of me is nothing. It's only what I create. Okay? So is you are here and you are Noah find grace in the eyes of Hashem is Noah and his Chen and is Noah again. Ele todot Noah. Noah is Tadik. It's two Noah. It's two Avraham. It's two Yeshua. It's two Yaakov. Everything is two. Why is two? Because it's one here and it's one inside. Avraham, Avraham, is Avraham here and is Avraham here. Moshe, Moshe, is Moshe here and Moshe here inside Godliness. The Moshe that is inside Godliness represent the existence of here, here. Now, Yisha is the same letter of Shaif, in opposite. When you get to a place of pure marble, Shaif is marble, don't say water, water. Now, all this is like low water and all this is like high water. If this is a firmament, so this is low water, this is high water. If we connect this to the Aleph above, this is low water and this is high water. The rectification of everything that the donkey will be one with Atik Yomim, and the woman with the son that she received as Ibur Neshama will be here, will be one too. And the two wings will be one too. It's like the two wings of Yishai. Did you understand this? Why the symmetry of the sun, the earth? In the time we gave many lessons about all the symmetry, and we did a lot of gematriot, a lot of fantastic gematriot with all the concepts that make connection between all the levels. And then we understand why Yishai or Miriam, let's say this is Miriam, the mother of Jesus. The Miriam is like a Rabbi Schneerson. She's his mother in this direction, and she's his mother in this direction. From two directions she's his mother, because this is the middle of the symmetry. Whatever we do here, we make happen here. Whatever we do in the consciousness world, we make it happen in the subconsciousness existence. Okay? Everything we do here, if we build the Beit HaMikdash here, so the Beit HaMikdash came from the heaven too. We just don't see it now. But when we will see it, it means we can see Mashiach too that came from above. Even if he grew as a plant from the ground, he came from above. Now, don't say water, water. It's all supposed to be one. In end of rectification.
When you get a correct perception,
the correct reality is really is not two Aleph, is one Aleph.
The correct perception of reality.
Exactly.
Because reality is just one reality. We don't have yet the correct perception.
Exactly. But problem. The correct perception, the way it will happen in the end,
to reach that level of consciousness,
it's really that the two Aleph will become one Aleph. Yeah. It's like to take a page and to do this. And then what was in the top become one with what below, etc. Okay, so it must, this is what happened, slowly, slowly. Slowly, slowly, this will be...
The fulfillment of the plan of Creator, eventually.
Okay, yeah. So this is all the concept of Chen, of symmetry, yeah, have to do with understanding this thing. It was from one side, Miriam, she is his mother. But from another side, Miriam, she is his disciple of Jesus. It means his daughter. The same Miriam. Supposed to be the same Miriam. In this world, not. Above Yishai, you have Oved. But maybe Oved is what you call the root of David, is Jesus. Eved Hashem. Oved is slave. The slave of God.
So the two characters, Miriam,
so you can understand
the
it.
And the mother are actually a reflection of the same.
Yeah, it's supposed to be. It's why the Torah gives you the same name, the same.
Mm-hmm.
It's all the idea. The Torah teaches you something. Why the same name?
Very interesting.
It means the son is a father. This is a generation coming from Yitzhak.
Same about the mother.
What are the generation coming from Yitzhak, son of Avraham? Avraham. So Avraham is the son of Yitzhak. Avraham that give birth to Yitzhak. So now Avraham is a father. That's why Avraham start with Av, what is a father, but the next two letters is Bar, what in Aramaic it means son. So you see that Avraham is the son of Yitzhak and is the father of Yitzhak too. It's why the priest, the disciple, they can make his Yitzhak, the rabbi is Yitzhak, can make him wise. Now, I explain a little bit more this Aleph. It is a simple model and it is a more complicated model. Let's go first of all for the simple model, for the simple model. We have here Abraham. We have here Yitzhak, and we have here Yaakov. And of course, we go opposite in the other side. Okay, so this is a donkey, this is Eliyahu Navi, Yitzhak equal Pinchas, Pinchas is Eliyahu, there are four letters equal four times Eliyahu, four sons, etc. And here Yaakov must be with Vav. Yaakov in this place is Yaakov with Vav. You have exactly the same weight like Avraham. Five letters. Remember when we learned this verse. Now, inside Yaakov, we have another thing. We have inside Yaakov, we have Esav. So, I will put this in another way. I try to make it simple. This is Yitzhak. This is Rabbi. This is a disciple, this is Rabbi. This is Yaakov. Yaakov is a rabbi here. And this is Esav. Avraham, Yitzhak, Yaakov, Esav, the snake that is inside the name of Yishai. The middle, one of the three names of Yishai is Nachash, snake. Right, so now Esav is it's why the horse is black. Because the black donkey, this is Esav. Now, we say that there are two personalities, Esav in the appearance of Avraham and Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzhak. These are two personalities and these ways are connected. Esav in the appearance of Avraham and Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzhak. But now understand that the Yaakov is a rabbi. It's the face of the man. This is the face of the bull. This is the face of the lion. Okay. Now in this place you have the face of the eagle. Okay. Now this a simple model. So what is the eagle? You have the same thing here. So this will be again Yaakov. You have Esav, Yaakov. This is like Yishai. What is Yishai? Yishai is Yishai. It's a rabbi. Let's take the two yud of Yishai. The rabbi, this is a rabbi and it's another rabbi. And in the middle you have the snake. Rabbi plus Rabbi equal Mashiach ben David. This is Mashiach ben David. Inside Mashiach ben David, you have the black donkey. Okay? And this is like Yaakov, face of man, Esav, face of evil in the middle. Yaakov, Yaakov, in the middle you have Esav. And you have the same symmetry above. This is a simple, more simple way to see it. But if we want to be precise, when we learn about the personality of Mashiach, we say that here we have Esav in the appearance of Abraham. Here we have Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzhak. No, I'm sorry. Here we have Yaakov in the appearance of Yitzhak. Here we have Rivka in the appearance of Sarah. Let's put it this way. Rivka in the appearance of Sarah. And here we have Yitzhak in the appearance of Abraham. Now this is the Yitzhak. It's like the other Aleph. Sarah is like Yitzhak. Sarah, the same soul of Yitzhak. She's a laughing. Rivka is the same soul like Avraham, the morning, Haboker, the letter of Yitzchak. So you have Avraham in the middle, and inside Avraham you have Esav, and you have in the both directions you have Yitzchak. Alright, so you have the bad guy in the middle, and you have the good guy, Yitzchak and Yaakov, as the two legs. Okay, because Rivka is like Avraham. And Yitzhak is like Sarah. What we did here, we took the family of Avraham and we took the family of Yitzhak, and we put clothing on top of the family of Yitzhak. We put clothing of the family of Avraham. So the first family is Yitzhak, his wife is Rivka, his son is Yaakov, the other son is Esav. This is the inner family, and the outer family is Avraham, Yitzhak in the face of Avraham, his wife is Sarah, his son is Yitzhak, and the other son is Ishmael. Now Avraham and Ishmael is like the same thing. Avraham came instead of Ishmael. Alright? Did you we talk about this in the past? Two families. One family, the family of Yitzhak. Yitzhak, his wife, his name is Rivka, and they have two sons, Yaakov and Yitzhak. So this is the first family. Yitzhak, Rivka, Yaakov, Esav. This family dress appear with the other family. It means the family of Abraham do a rectification. Rectification is tikkun, is dressing to the family of Yitzhak. Now, Yitzhak appear in the face of Avraham, Rivka appear in the face of Yitzhak, Yaakov appear in the face of Yitzhak, and Esav appear in the face of Ishmael. What? Ishmael is not relevant in the correction right now, so he's a priest too, so we can put Avraham, because Avraham is a priest. So this for one, who want to get more to detail?
Why do we need that?
In other way, you receive the symmetry here. This is what is important. You receive Avraham in the middle and Yitzhak in the two sides. What Hakol the man? The Torah says about a man, Dak, Mechuspas, is the place of the tree of knowledge, good and evil. Dak, Mechuspas, Dak. Mechuspas equal Avraham. Dak, Dak. Mechuspas, it's not smooth. Inside the man, was mechuspas. Mechuspas, it's like evil. It's like it's not smooth.
With spines.
Yeah, it's mechuspas. And dak is mean is thin. It's thin. It's delicate. Dak tak equal Yitzchak. Why is mechuspa? Because it's Esav inside Avraham. The black donkey. And Yitzchak is a white horse. So the white horse is outside, dak, equal white horse. Sus Lavan equal Yitzchak. And inside you have Avraham. Inside Avraham you have Esav. Okay? You understand this? I want to show you the symmetry of Avraham in the middle before I put Esav in the middle. It's the same thing. You can put Avraham here and Esav here. And you can sense that Avram is here, and inside Avram here is Esav. It doesn't matter.